Amen.
Do we have anyone for an invocation?
No.
You. You go ahead. Y'all good to start?
Call this meeting of the Brookhaven City Council for December 13th, 2016 to order. We have a spot for invocation. If anybody would like to say a prayer, anybody willing to come up to the council and open us in prayer? If not, we'll have a moment of silence to begin the meeting. Thank you. Madam Clerk, would you call the order?
Mayor Pro Tem Bates Madison.
Here.
Councilmember Joe Gebbia, District 4.
Here.
Councilmember John Park, here. District 2.
Here.
Councilmember Lindley Jones, District 1.
Present.
And our mayor has temporarily stepped out. Thank you.
Be right back. Let's say the Pledge of Allegiance. Stand for the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Get back. Okay. I'm here now. So, Emery. There you go.
Our lifeline pet of the week is Foxy. She's a 5-year-old lab shepherd mix. This sweet lady was an instant staff favorite the minute she walked in the door. She gets along well with other dogs and has a lot of life ahead of her. During December, Lifeline is offering a Joy to the World special where all dogs over 25 pounds and all cats are $25. And that includes examination, spaying, neutering, microchipping. And you can view Foxy and more like her at www.lifelineanimal.org.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm going to skip ahead and go into plaques and commendation. Gary, commendations.
Okay, Deputy Chief and Sergeant Lewis come up. Mayor, members of council, it's a great pleasure. I'd like to introduce there's an elite group out on Georgia State Patrol that have been assisting us since we started. If you remember when we first started on Long Buford Highway, we were having a number of armed robberies. We're still having them. But we sought assistance, and Colonel McDonough from Georgia State Patrol said, any assistance you guys need, let us know and we'll be there to help you. So they've been helping us weekly, actually, and this is an elite group. They're the Atlanta Nighthawks. They help us with DUIs, with crime suppression, or everything that we could possibly ask for. So we'd like to recognize them today and present them with some certificates and a plaque for their office. They actually, their second office, I hope, is our office too at our station. So if you want to come up, guys, and first one is Sergeant First Class John Cronin. He's one of the supervisor of the Nighthawks North. Actually, there's 10 troopers that are involved in this program up in our area. Thank you. Trooper First Class Lenny Mullen. Okay. Who's here? Okay. Trooper First Class James Pylon. Trooper First Class Andrew Pacifine. Very good. And Trooper First Class Michael Tennant. And just to let you know, too, you know, we've lost three cars to DUI drivers out on Buford Highway. These guys lost at least three cars, I think, out on Buford Highway assisting us and helping us. So some of them, they initiated themselves. So, but we appreciate all their efforts. We also have the plaque, as I mentioned, for their office. It's just presented to Georgia State Patrol Nighthawks North in appreciation for your assistance and partnership with traffic enforcement and criminal apprehension, the Brookhaven Police Department, December 2016.
You would need to.
Got this problem.
That's a great second team. Thank you.
And then next, we'll do the appointments.
We've got one more.
Sorry, presentation. I apologize.
Next one, it's a couple that's helped us out tremendously again since we started. They were members of our First Citizens Police Academy. Yes. And if you don't know it, they're overfeeding us at the police station. I mean, we started the Christmas dinners. They started, I think, the first year. They did our anniversary luncheon. They actually come to the station the last couple of years and decorated the whole police department for us. So with citizens like this, the police department can't go wrong. So we'd like to present Emily Haas and her husband, Dr. Joseph Haas, certificates and a nice plaque. And this basically says certificate of commendation, both of them are the same, to Joseph and Emily, in recognition of your assistance, dedication, unwavering support to the Brookhaven Police Department, presented by the Brookhaven Police Department, December 13, 2016. So.
Say how happy on behalf of all of the citizens of Brookhaven we are to have y'all. Where you came along, 911 calls in DeKalb County, they can only answer violent crimes. And you guys show up in minutes. It's just so nice to have you.
Well, how beautiful.
Thank you.
That is so sweet.
Thanks, Gary. And we're going to skip ahead to appointments to get them. Luckily, at this point, I'm going to nominate some people to our audit committee. That's our first foundation people of the audit committee. It's Susan Nichols, Mike Harold, Norman McKay, and Tim Tripp is. Bill, do you want to say anything about this group of folks? Bill, our internal auditor? Yeah.
So I've provided their resumes, and of course, they've all passed background checks too with the police department. But aside from that, they're all of CPAs, certified internal auditors, and a CFO. They all have the appropriate credentials to serve on this committee. Two of them are residents of Brookhaven, and the other two are officers of companies domiciled here in Brookhaven. So they meet all the qualifications to be on the Audit Advisory Committee.
And Bill, if you could tell what the Audit Advisory Committee will do for the public large.
The Audit Advisory Committee is provides for the mayor and city council, in effect, the knowledge to know that when I come before the committee, that what I'm saying or what I've audited has been reviewed by a set, these four people, sets of eyes on the numbers, on the recommendations, which cuts down on the amount of time that the mayor and city council has to spend on such issues, and at the same time, it lets you know that people that are experts in that field have in fact looked at it before it gets to you.
Thank you so much, and thanks so much for. Well, I made the nominations. Obviously, I will have to vote on that.
I move that we. Oh, can we make a motion?
Yeah, please do.
I move that we approve the slate of nominees as stated.
I second.
Motion second. All those in favor, say aye.
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 Well, congratulations or condolences, whatever you may choose, and thank you so much. We took a picture earlier in the back so that we didn't have to move on. So, again, thanks so much for doing this. It's a real, you know, it's great having citizens looking over our books and our audit, and so provide great financial sounding for us going forward.
I don't think they're still here, but if anybody wants to meet one member, Mr. Tripp is in the back. Mr. Tripp, you want to wave?
Yeah.
Okay, thank that's you. The one. Thank you.
Well, and
oh, Mike.
And Cheryl. Okay. So two again. Thanks so much, guys.
Mr. Harrell, thank you. Sorry.
Okay, we'll move on to public hearings. Consideration and approval of ordinance annexation 1601, Woodcliff Annexation.
This item and the subsequent four items will be heard together. Annexation 1601, Woodcliff Annexation. This item was heard at the December 7th Planning Commission hearing. The four rezoning cases, not the actual annexation. This annexation is being brought to you pursuant to the request by the property owners under the 60% rule. All standards have been met. DeKalb County has been notified as required, and the staff recommends approval of the request. The first rezoning case is RZ 1611 for 2622 Briarcliff Road, the Executive Park Townhomes. This request is to rezone from RSM to RA8. Staff is recommending approval conditional of the request, and Planning Commission also recommended approval. Rezoning RZ 1612, 1698 Woodcliff Drive for the Executive Parkview Townhomes. This is a request to rezone from RSM to RA8. Staff and Planning Commission are recommending approval conditional of the request. RZ 1613 related to 1705 and 1721 Woodcliff Drive. The two single family residential lots are being proposed to rezone from R85 to RA8. Staff is recommending approval conditional, and Planning Commission did the same. Planning Commission did have some concerns about the public notice because this is a proposal to take the two single family lots to a townhome development. The applicant will have details about their public notice requirements under the DeKalb rezoning process as a part of their presentation. And the final case is RZ 1614, 2580 Briarcliff Road for the Executive Park Apartments. and the request is to rezone from MR2 to RM85, and both staff and Planning Commission are recommending approval.
Real quick, I guess, is there any statement from city manager first before I?
No, that I appreciate the efforts of the Community Development Department and the city attorney's office to guide the community through this process. The city departments have made all the requisite analysis of service impacts, police, public works, parks, and we see no concerns about added workload given the size of this annexation.
Sounds good. And at this point, I'll open public hearing. We'll have the applicant. Why don't you go ahead and do the...
Well, first of all, I'd like to confirm, if we're doing it concurrently, there's five items, so I'm assuming 50 minutes, correct?
We've discussed it with the applicant and the public that it would just be the 10, 10, 10.
Just 10, 10, 10. Mm-hmm. Perfect. Thank you. And to remind everyone of our decorum rules, please be nice and polite and follow all the rules throughout the rest of the meeting. Thank you.
Okay, so with the opening of public hearing, I have applicant for 10 minutes.
Before we start, I'd like to ask the representatives, we have some of the representatives from the Woodcliff area here, if they could just stand for a moment. Just thank you. Hi, I'm Rick Bennett, the HOA president for Executive Parkview Townhomes. I'm one of the five properties being discussed tonight. For brevity, I will be speaking on behalf of all five properties, as well as the items 1 through 5. We do have representatives here from the different properties to help answer questions if anyone has any questions. The properties included in the annexation request consist of 113 parcels, approximately 19 acres, and we actually group them into some common areas that we basically typically refer to them as. The first area would be Executive Park Apartments. It consists of 50 brick apartments on one parcel, about 3.8 acres. The second group would be Executive Park Condominiums. It consists of Executive Park Condominiums consist of 59 brick townhomes on 61 parcels, roughly 7.4 acres. These are built in the early 70s. Executive Park View Townhomes consist of 48 stucco townhomes on 49 parcels and about 6.6 acres, built in the late 70s. We also included two single-family homes, actually behind the trees, and these are at the end of Woodcliff Drive. These were built in the 1950s. Now, these two parcels consist of 1.1 acre, and as we'll discuss later, they're currently under contract for potential redevelopment of 9 townhomes. And of course, with the development, our surrounding properties do support this. The annexation area also consists of one street, Woodcliff Drive, and it's approximately 900 feet long, and it actually dead ends at the entrance to Executive Park View Townhomes and the single family homes. This is kind of an odd picture from Google, but you can see this is the end of Woodcliff Drive, where on the left is Executive Park View Townhomes, on the right is the driveways to the single family homes. And actually part of this land, mostly where you can see the line, is actually on private land, and it's maintained by our HOA. That's just kind of a different view, but as you may be aware, in 2014, the owners within our properties began performing due diligence in consideration of requesting annexation into the city of Brookhaven. In August 2016, after 21 months of research and discussions, all property owners and electors within these properties voted on annexation using the 60% method. Based on overwhelming support, we moved forward with our request for annexation. And as a reference of those returning ballots, 88% actually supported the annexation of those returning the ballots. So the question is, why did we seek annexation? Well, I can't really speak for all the owners, because every owner had their own different ideas, different opinions, different, you know, combinations of thoughts. But some of the overall supporting factors were the exceptional police service offered by Brookhaven Police Department. And actually, that was probably the number one, so really, for our owners. Many owners have been watching the city since it was formed, and our owners really like the way that the city is moving, the direction it's moving, the way the officials actually listen to the citizens and respond accordingly. And that's one thing that, you know, was really impressed a lot of our people that have been watching the city itself. We were previously in the La Vista Hills annexation map, as well as the Atlanta annexation maps back in 2014. And one of the concerns is that, you know, we're kind of primed for annexation, you know, for people just land grabbing us. And we didn't know what would be the, you know, what would be the future. Our owners, many of our owners felt we want to pick our future. And we really like Brookhaven, so let's move forward with Brookhaven. Further, given our unique location, we're actually completely contiguous with Brookhaven to the west and the north. If you look to the, you know, basically the left side of the map as well as the top, that is Brookhaven. Unincorporated DeKalb is the right side as well as the bottom. So geographically, we already feel like we're part of Brookhaven. Just a little bit about us. Our demographics consist of a variety of religions, races, ages, economic levels, retired professionals who've lived on our property for almost 40 years, and a lot of new younger professionals buying their first home. Our units are over 2,000 square feet with two-car garages, and our prices are range from $250,000 to $350,000. We believe we offer an affordable option for people who want to live in the area. While our properties are older, many of our homeowners in the HOAs are investing a lot of time and money into the property, as well as our infrastructure improvements, because our goal is for our complexes to stay around for a long time. For these reasons, and among other reasons, our residents are requesting annexation. Just so you know, we did due diligence. Part of that was that we provided a spreadsheet to all of the owners, providing them an option to compare 2015 property taxes from unincorporated DeKalb to as well as Brookhaven, so they could see what the tax differences would be. Actually, for most owners, our property taxes would increase about $100. Mine would be $108. Even after that, a lot of our owners felt that was still, you know, they still supported it. They felt that it was completely worth it. Also, as part of our due diligence, before we submitted our annexation, we actually wanted to make sure that we'd be a positive addition to the city and that we wouldn't be a burden. We wanted to find out what other Brookhaven residents thought. So a lot of our residents actually had unofficial conversations with residents throughout Brookhaven as well as businesses and try to get their input. And we always received positive feedback from these residents. Based on that, we felt comfortable moving forward with a request for annexation. We also did extensive outreach to neighboring communities to inform them of our efforts. We sent emails, printed, mailed letters. We invited other people to informational meetings. And we even went door-to-door on Childerly to, you know, let them know what's going on. As far as city services, when it comes to annexation, three of the five properties were actually private and self-contained in that we pretty much maintain our own underground water, sewer lines, storm drain lines, as well as our own roads and asphalt. If the two single-family homes are redeveloped into townhomes, then essentially all the properties will be self-supporting. The city would assume responsibility for Woodcliff Drive in the right-of-way, and we're really not asking for any improvements anytime soon, so we know we'll be on the list eventually, but we're not asking for anything. As a matter of fact, some of our residents actually volunteer to help maintain the landscaping in the right-of-way, as well as some of our residents even fill the potholes. So we just go and get bags of asphalt and fill it up. So we're pretty low maintenance, you know, at least we try to be. As for other services and things other than the street and police, basically, you know, they're provided by the county or by our HO or our own private contractors through our HOAs. And I believe we're going to talk about the rezoning aspect as part of this. So all five items. So I'll just go ahead and address that. As part of the annexation application, our understanding is that our areas have to be rezoned from the naming convention for unincorporated DeKalb to the Brookhaven naming convention. And so that's part of the, I guess, item two through five. So looking at this for the Executive Park Apartments, again, it's currently MR2, and we're asking for RM85. For Executive Park Condominiums, we're asking for RSM to RA8. For Executive Park View Townhomes, again, also RSM to RA8, as well as for the two single-family homes, which, again, is a slightly different situation, we're actually asking for you to change that from R85, which is DeKalb, to RA8 for Brookhaven. That would actually make all of Woodcliff Drive RA8 and, you know, allow for a small townhome development on the two single-family, the properties with the two single-family homes. And I will just go ahead and say, and actually Dan Cotter with Minerva Homes is here to give a little bit of information about the development. But I will say that based on the location of the two single family homes, our residents feel that the small development of the 9 townhomes makes sense. Because of how it's surrounded by basically townhomes and apartments, no one's gonna come in and build a house. So really the only use for that would be to basically build a small townhome development or a green space, which really would not be financially feasible to be honest. So, but we do support the development. So I'll go ahead and...
You got a minute and a half.
Minute and a half? Oh, so, okay, do you want to hear about the development or...
Your call.
So, or we can defer and...
Whatever you want to, real quick. I guess he'll be under support. Okay.
Okay.
Opposition.
Well.
Opposition usually comes before.
Okay. But we'll listen to you and support just real quick. We'll. Okay. So
I defer.
So I think that's. Thank you very much. And is there any opposition? We can ask questions later if we need to.
I don't have any cards for opposition.
Any opposition out there? Seeing none or hearing none. Support.
Okay, and I have Dan Cotter, and the time starts at 10 again.
Yep, thank you.
And he wanted you all to look at this. There was only one copy.
Oh, sorry, I got it.
Oh, okay, perfect. Yep.
I think you all are very familiar with the site at this point, but...
Name and address.
Oh, sorry. Dan Cotter, Minerva Homes, 2292 Henderson Mill Road. I think you all are very familiar with the site at this point, but just in case you had any questions, I thought those materials would help orient. So we've essentially completed the rezoning process in DeKalb County for the two houses at the other end at the end of the street. Last week, the Planning Commission had some questions about our planning process with DeKalb. So I'll give you a quick summary. We applied to DeKalb to change the site's... Oh, thank you. Zoning category from R85 to RSM to build 9 townhomes at a density of 7.9 units per acre. Brookhaven's RE8 zoning category... is comparable to DeKalb's RSM category. RE8 will match the zoning of the other townhomes being annexed. We started the process with DeKalb by inviting all the property owners within 500 feet of the property to a community meeting to view the initial site plan and get their feedback. We had about 30 attendees, 17 signed in. And got some great feedback, which we've incorporated into the site plan that you see before you tonight. As a result, we received unanimous support from DeKalb's Community Council. 4 residents attended to ask questions. One, being Rick, showed up to voice his support. None opposed. We also got unanimous support from the DeKalb Planning Commission, and understandably, DeKalb's Board of Commissioners didn't want to take final action on property being annexed. So they deferred it to allow us to pick up where we left off if the property was not annexed. We're excited about joining your city and creating a great addition to the community. Thanks for your time, and I look forward to your feedback, and I'm happy to answer any questions you have about the proposal, our process, and so on.
Are they all this easy for you?
It's been a long one. it's been a great community process. And sometimes the feedback that we get is easier to integrate than others with our own needs. But this time, I think it's really made the plan stronger and. Been a good process.
What's the asking price on what you're going to be building here?
I got a colleague in the back room. Ben, what's our latest projection? $450,000 to $500,000.
Excellent. It's going to be good for the neighborhood.
Thanks, sir.
So, nothing else? Any other support? Because we're actually in public hearing, public hearing at this point. We can maybe ask questions later if we need to. So is there any other support? Seeing none, I'm going to close the public hearing. And we're in the consideration and approval of the annexation. And
Don't leave yet.
Don't leave yet.
Come on back. Sorry, if you wouldn't mind. I have a question about the zoning. So these properties that you've got on the Woodcliff Drive, 1705, 1721.
Yes, sir.
This is dealing with item number 4 on our council agenda. Is that right?
This is number 3, sir. It's RZ 1613.
It is number 4.
Yeah,
it's number 4.
Sorry. Oh, it is number 4.
You McGee got shifted, at least on my computer. So the proposed, let me make sure I'm reading this right. The proposal was for the city to zone this as RA8.
Yes, sir.
And is the proposed drawing that you've got in this concept, would that require RM85, or would this be doable under RA8?
That is totally within the RA8 zoning requirements,
yeah. Okay.
And I'm sure Patrice can
That's correct.
Comment from an unbiased perspective.
Good, thanks. That was my only question.
Thanks, sir.
Okay, we're consideration of, go back real quick. Consideration and approval of the ordinance annexation 16-1 Woodcliff annexation. Is there a motion?
Yes, I'm going to make a motion. And Patrice, we're dealing with just RZ 11 through 14, correct?
First, you have to do the annexation.
Well, first, we have to do the annexation.
Okay,
you
can, great.
Then you have to do each rezoning individually.
Correct, gotcha. I moved for approval, consideration approval of annexation of the Woodcliff request.
Is there a motion? Is there a second?
Second.
A motion and second. Let's go ahead.
Okay. Conversation, correct?
Yeah.
Rick, you did a great job. I mean, you did a stellar job. We've been in conversation for an extended period of time, and you've done this the best I've ever seen it done. So I just want to give you accolades for that. And I think this conversation started over 2 years ago, and it takes time. And it's one thing I found out sitting in this chair, you don't get things done quickly, but it went really smooth. You did it right. Everybody was involved. I mean, look how smooth this was. This was great. To everybody out there, I am going to be your councilman in District 4. Welcome aboard. I'm looking forward. I've already been invited to one of your HOA meetings coming up. Look forward to meeting all of you. Yes, I do drink beer and I eat cake, so I'll turn it to my other council members.
Okay, Bates, you want to
go? Just a question for staff on the money side. Did you have an analysis of what the revenue versus costs are going to be for the city? Can you give me that rundown, please?
I believe that was part of your package. I believe the additional tax revenues to the city were approximately $30,000. Based on the feedback from the various departments of the city, any increased cost for providing additional services will be nominal at best. As part of the process, we did provide the methodology for the potential residents in this annexed area to calculate the difference in their taxes as unincorporated DeKalb County residents versus City of Brookhaven residents.
And it was a benefit for them? Benefit?
It was a slight increase in their taxes.
Oh, ouch. Sorry about that, folks. And you still want to come. Thank you. Chief, any changes in the beats or your zones?
No, not at all. It adjoins the current property we currently patrol, so.
That's all the questions I have.
John?
I'm good.
All right. Chief? Did you have an opportunity to analyze whether there's a significant amount of crime that has occurred there, any demand on police resources that would be?
We pulled our statistics and we pulled what we could from the mapping in DeKalb County. However, it's difficult to get other statistics from DeKalb from previous years. So, but what we pulled, it's reasonable.
Okay, and I always like to hear from you that you're fine.
We're okay with
the
it.
Police department's commitment before we make a commitment. So thank
sure.
you for that.
Well, I was I guess I got a email account or email said, hey, can you want to meet out? And I think I responded to you in about 20 minutes. I said, oh, I didn't want to do any work any that day, so I drove down and looked through your property. It was a great property. Was it the fourth highest point in DeKalb County? It was one of the top, so we're adding probably our new highest point in Brookhaven at this point. If we vote for this. But I commend you at residents for going through this process. I look forward to you guys joining the city. I see this as a win-win. Any other comments, folks? Seeing none, all those in favor, say aye.
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 Aye. Unanimous 4-0. Welcome to Brookhaven.
Thank you.
Now we get to rezone you. So, how do you want to, Patrice, how do you want,
all
can we do
months.
It?
Each individually.
Okay. I'll need a motion on the next, on RZ 1611.
Okay, I would like to move that council approve RZ 1611, City of Brookhaven, rezoning to RA8 to maintain existing uses and conditions.
Just a second.
Second.
Any comment? Seeing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Passed. Next.
I would like to also move that council approve RZ 16-12, City of Brookhaven, rezoning to RA8 to maintain existing uses south of I-85, east of North.
Second.
Second by Bates. Any comment? Seeing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Next.
Furthermore, I'd like to request approval for RZ 16-13, City of Brookhaven, rezoning to RA8 to maintain DeKalb County approved existing land use.
Second.
Motion second. Any comment? Seeing none. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Unanimous.
And finally, I request approval for RZ 16-14, City of Brookhaven, rezoning to RM85 to maintain existing uses south of I-85, east of.
Second.
Motion second.
I have a question. This is the last one, right?
Mm-hmm.
All the recommended staff conditions and planning commission are being captured in this motion, right?
They are.
Okay.
Okay.
Good question. Thank you.
Any other comments? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
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 Unanimous. Well, again, congratulations. Welcome to Brookhaven.
Hey, stick around, guys. It's going to stay exciting.
Yeah. Yeah. Going to mayor's announcements. First, I will do a proclamation of the City of Brookhaven's birthday, which is on the 17th of December. Okay. Whereas the City of Brookhaven, DeKalb County was officially incorporated as a city on December 17th, 2012, it is the largest municipality in DeKalb County with a population more of 51,000 and about 200. It added. Whereas since inception, the city has strived to provide its citizens excellent services, including police, parks, public works. And whereas it's fitting to accordingly officially recognize the City of Brookhaven's fourth birthday on December 17, 2016. And whereas to acknowledge the dedication, the hard work of the City of Brookhaven's founders and the commitment to the city's officials and staff. And whereas also expressed appreciation to the continued support of the city's residents, volunteers, and community partners. Therefore, I, John Ernst, by authority vested in me as mayor of City of Brookhaven, do I recognize the city's birthday. And so we are having a small little celebration for staff on this Friday. Anyone who wants to stop by, I think there's some cake and such. And it's our fourth birthday. We'll probably have something a little bit bigger for our fifth next year. So that's that. Comment on birthday.
As soon as you said 4 years, Bates and I just looked at each other, and we're the last two of the original council members, and I looked at him and I said, seems a lot longer than 4 years. And he shook his head, yes.
Gotten some grays.
I will go on wishing, this is our last meeting of the year, so wishing everyone a happy holidays. Happy New Year, safe New Year too, safe travels. Again, thank the effort of all the staff. This is our last meeting of the year, so thanks the effort of all the staff and the citizens and the volunteers out there. Exactly, the boards and the commissions that are volunteers for the most part. Also, our public works department is going to be working 24 hours a day, even during the holidays. We'll have someone on call and on staff. So if there's a problem, let public works should answer the phone and get to it. And if there's a major emergency, everything will be going. Also, again, with the holidays, remember our military that are out there protecting our freedoms. who are overseas, and our police officers who are protecting us here at home during the holiday season. And so I'd like to thank all of them. Any comments with you, Joe? Any more?
Just remember our neighbors up in the Chattanooga area who are not going to be having a very happy Christmas this year. And I know there's a lot of opportunities to contribute for funds that will help them out, so keep them in mind.
Bates? John? Lindley?
In addition to wishing you all happy holidays, which of course I do, I would like you all to know that tomorrow is the deadline for giving input and feedback to the consultants on the Ashford-Dunwoody Corridor Study. It has been many, many months in the works. Hundreds of community participants have weighed in, but the feedback is still being accepted by the consultants for incorporation and consideration in the final plan through tomorrow. So if you wish to give feedback, the more specific, the better. Please email it to adcorridorstudy@brookhavenga.gov, and you have through midnight tomorrow night to get in those emails, and then the consultants will finalize the plans. They will go through staff for staff adjustments, and then they will be presented to City Council, will be the next step. I don't believe that date for presentation to council has been set yet, but at that point, we will look forward to hearing from residents directly to us on council.
Okay. With that, any agenda announcements? Seeing none, public comment.
We have a good many public comments for the PDK item, which is at the end of the agenda. And I just want to remind everybody there's a 3-minute time limit per person, but there's a maximum time limit of 30 minutes. So, and also remember your rules on the public comment card. And please no clapping or anything, any outburst in the audience. Thank you.
And if you could have do we have a list of everyone here?
I'll start entering them.
Okay. Well, I mean, if you announce the next person. It's if you're having public comment and you're next, if you could come up and get in line so that, you know, we can move quickly.
They're separated for opposition and support, but this is not like a public hearing, so I could go back and forth between the two or.
Thank you.
How do you want to?
Yeah, fair. Yeah, fine.
Which way?
Go back and forth.
Okay. All right, the first one for opposition is Ronnie Mayer.
And that was just on the PDK or just everything?
That's what we have here is PDK.
So I can just talk about PDK?
That's what?
It's public comment. He can talk about anything right, he wants for 3 minutes.
All right, public comment. The study on Ashford-Dunwoody Road. How much of my tax? Oh, I'm Ronnie Mayer, 2709 Redding Road, community leader in Brookhaven. How much of my tax dollars was spent on this study, or was it all from the DOT or feds? A lot or no? Or
we can ask that after.
Okay. Well, I'm looking at this plan here, and I'm a businessman around here. I drive the roads every day. Whoever came up with this, and if we paid for them, needs to be shot. This will not work. I'll email whoever. I have my wife do it, but this is the most asinine plan I've ever seen. But if it'll be. But this thing with the airport deal, City of Brookhaven has not even fixed the parks we have now. The City of Shamley is just acquired a park on Dresden, got a beautiful big sign out front, City of Shamley. We have no signs in any of our parks to say they belong to Brookhaven. It's sad. Here y'all are trying to spend $5 million on a piece of property, and then you come out and say that you want to swap and you want to do the service center over there. Let's run this city like a business, okay? The service center is not our job. That belongs to the state. Let's let them do it, not our city, okay? So if we're going to do something, our city didn't ever stop behind us with the school system, you know, the school over there off Skyland Drive. That's a problem there. The school buses, all of y'all are young. When us old guys were around, the buses used to enter from the entrance off the old entrance there in Buford Highway and Claremont. They came into the school. They did a loop. The intersection at Dresden Drive and Skyland will not hold a school bus doing the turn there. It's too sharp. What I'd like to see be done is swap out the property and let's build the new elementary school in the front of that property. Let's let your private school go back to Skyland, and then the rear side of that property be used as a Brookhaven Park, because you don't want an entrance to the park on Claremont, because every criminal that wants to come in is going to pull in the driveway and say, here's a place to do criminal activity. I just wish that y'all would drink a little coffee, wake up. Let's fix the stuff that needs to be fixed now. Joe spent $10,000 on a study for a monorail. Come on, Joe.
I can't.
If that was your money, you wouldn't spend it on that. That's my tax money you spend. I'm glad we got these brand new people that are going to help pay for some of these stupid studies y'all do around here. But I still love y'all all. But drink a little coffee and wake up a little bit. Happy New Year. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Ronnie. Love you.
We have Lynn Brown and then Lauren.
Who was that?
Lynn Brown.
Lynn Brown.
You don't want to speak? I don't know why you got the name. It's just comment in general. Whether you support or oppose.
Next.
How about the Lauren? I couldn't read the handwriting. Lorinthia? Okay, sorry. Couldn't read your handwriting.
I'm sorry, I'm trying real hard. If I may, I wish you a Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Happy birthday. You're all invited to our little shops. I don't know if that's ethical, Mayor. You can tell me, but for your birthday, please come and enjoy the wonderful restaurants. Number one, Atlanta Journal-Constitution, sushi, India, around the world, Righteous Room, British Pub, Italian. And they unfortunately are very disturbed by the solid median in front by the proposed Ashford corridor that will stop 50% of access to them. They've seen what happened on Jimmy Carter. All those businesses went out of business because there was no access. The light at Donaldson Drive is being removed and changed to a right turn out, right turn in only. I've been to the meetings. I work late. I come late, but I was there. My children were there. We were told at the Marist meeting there would be no solid median. And we were surprised 11 business days ago to find one and to see we have 11 business days to respond to something that will put all of these stores out of business. Walgreens, Corner Pizza, you know the little restaurants there. We have a new tenant in the old Blockbuster. We used it for charity for the orphans in Jamaica and would load it up with donations, and Food for the Poor would come and take it once or twice a year. And we've decided to rent it to Olympic Gymnastics. So let's have a gold medal winner here. That's called the Peach Pit Gymnasium. This solid median also stops emergency vehicles from getting to the four regional hospitals rather than maneuvering around a middle lane like we're asking for. And you can have all my land you want for free. Just give us access to our businesses. You can have anything you want for free. Just put in a turning lane like you have on Peachtree or anywhere rather than a solid median. We beg of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Next.
All right, we have Thomas Swindeman and then Jim Iyer. Oh, excuse me, Adam Caskey, then Thomas Swindeman, and then Jim Iyer.
Good evening. My name is Adam Caskey. I live at 1894 Toby Road, which is actually right next to the green space. But I'm here to speak on behalf of the many, many, many BIA families that emails you guys in the past week or so. And as you know, The families have expressed a desire to be placed on a portion of the green space, with the vast majority of the green space staying as green space. But the most important thing that I would like you to hear from those emails is that there is a strong desire in the BIA community to come home. And that is the case of regardless of the outcome of any vote on any particular piece of property. I think it's also important for you to know that the dream of BIA that started here is now an absolute reality. The school is changing lives. I can tell you that I am absolutely amazed by the growth that my 8-year-old son has experienced in just 4 months. And I'm absolutely thrilled that I'm able to send my daughter there next year when she begins kindergarten. So basically, I am here to represent, I believe it was more than 100 parents that emailed you, just to say, please don't forget about us. And I'll also say that this school is going to excel no matter where it is. But I've lived in Brookhaven my entire adult life. And as a citizen of Brookhaven, to me it would be a travesty for this unbelievable institution that was founded by this council to not ultimately make its way home. So again, my message is short, but I think it needs to be heard. Please do not forget about us. As a citizen, I want this school back here, selfishly. I think that this city should forever be associated with all the good that this school will do. So please engage the parents. Please engage the board of BIA, which we have representatives here tonight. And please do whatever you can within reason to help us come home. Thank you.
Thomas Wendeman.
Hi, I'm Thomas Wendeman. I live at 2967 Skyland Drive. I wish you all a good evening. I am for the proposed purchase of the PDK green space to be left as green space. If we do not purchase this property now, I've seen the value of the property actually go up in just 3 years' time, doubled from $3 million approximately to almost $6 million now. So I urge you to go ahead and approve the contract and move forward on keeping the land green space, because if it's developed, we're going to have flooding problems in the future. That's just going to happen. Thank you.
Jim Meyer, and then Eddie Ihart. Ihart.
That's enough. Good evening. Here sort of to ask to put the brakes on the Brookhaven purchase of the green space property. It's not fully vetted. There are a lot of options that you need to consider, but the bottom line is to take $6 million of my tax money and put it toward the purchase of a green space. While it may be an admirable position to take, that's money that is supposed to be devoted to parks, to paving, and to police. If you want to take and go off on a venture and do things that are outside of paving, parks, and police, that's fine. Put together a list, tell us what it's going to cost, and put it out for a referendum. When we voted for the city, and when we voted all along, we did not vote for obscure funding of things that were pet projects of councilmen. And as you've heard from others, even if you do buy it, there are opportunities to recoup some of the cost, very legitimate opportunities to recoup some of the cost, whether it's the service center, whether it's Brookhaven Academy, whether it's a soccer complex to bring tournament soccer into Brookhaven. There are parts of that property that are not pristine green space and do not need to be preserved. They need to be put to use for something that benefits the city of Brookhaven. So at this time, we're getting outside, well over our skis of what the city should be doing: paving, police, and parks. Spend the $5 or $6 million on fixing our roads, fixing our parks, and making sure our police are well equipped and staffed. Finally, Councilman Parks, I've read your appraisal. Despite what you said at the last meeting, there's nothing in there that says you will not benefit from this transaction. Therefore, despite the mayor's suggestion that you get an appraisal to try to justify your vote, I think the fact that you even had to think about getting an appraisal suggested that it's not something you should be voting on. You should recuse yourself from this vote. You will benefit financially from this transaction, and therefore you must recuse yourself from your vote tonight and for any further discussions or votes on this matter. Thank you.
Eddie Eyart and then Kathleen Hartnett.
Good evening and happy holidays, everyone. I'm Eddie Eyart. I live at 1821 Duke Road, where I have since 1983. I'm here to speak on preservation of the Ashford Forest green space, which, aside from being the last large pristine piece of property of its type in this part of the county, is something that does speak to the primary reasons of incorporation, which were not just paving, but roads and drainage. We have had substantial stormwater problems downstream from that area, primarily in Drew Valley over the years, that were brought about by undue and inappropriate clearing of forest areas and no additional stream buffer replacement. This is a stormwater sink. Something it does there without costing us a penny, without any additional paving being necessary, without any diversion, is suck up all the rain that falls on it and produce a perpetual stream that is, even in the drought 3 weeks ago, was still flowing. It would be foolish to tamper with this natural system of drainage and produce flooding problems downstream on Tributary A of the North Fork of Peachtree Creek for all of the citizens living there. And not to mention, it provides a place for all of our children to still see what this area is supposed to look like. I encourage you to vote to purchase this property before any more unnecessary diversions are thrown at you, any more uncalled for price increases are developed, or any more artificial impediments are placed in your path. Thank you very much.
Kathleen.
Hi there. I'm the parent of a kindergartner at Brookhaven Innovation Academy. My husband and I actually live just north of the city of Decatur, and we're really lucky to have really wonderful public schools there. But we took a risk on this school in its very first year, and I just have to say we are absolutely thrilled that we did. Both my husband and I are scientists at CDC, and having that focus on STEM and computer programming and foreign language and things that some of the other local schools aren't providing has been incredible for us. And now we just need a home. So the parents who I've met at the school are so motivated and so dedicated, and they are driving out to Norcross on Saturday to plant trees out there. So when I heard about, you know, the possibility of potentially developing this small, you know, non-pristine part of the green space, I was absolutely captivated by the idea, because we could help here in Brookhaven. So you could have a school on the site, hopefully a small portion of it, where the kids could get into the forest. They could learn about the ecosystems. They could help clean up that stream. You know, instead of planting trees in Norcross, we could be maintaining the trails in the green space, and, you know, also potentially paying rent or contributing to the city in some other way that would be a win-win. So, you know, from my understanding of it, is that the current contract that you're voting on tonight, you know, doesn't allow a school in the next 5 years. And I would just ask, you know, postpone it for a little bit. See if potentially DeKalb County might be willing to go ahead with a different idea for the site. I know we're late to the game, but I was so delighted to hear this idea. It really captivated me, and I'm just asking you to consider it. Thank you so much.
Mariana Yates and Lori Geary.
Hi,
Hi, I'm Mariana Yates at 1895 9th Street. I'm here in support of purchasing the PDK green space. I want you to understand green space is not an indulgence or a luxury, it's a necessity to people, plants, and wildlife. Green space provides clean air and water, flood management, and a noise abatement, habitat, and increases the overall quality of life and health of our citizens. This land is the only remaining stand of forest of this size in Brookhaven or in the surrounding areas. It is a precious natural resource and a treasure to the community. The truth is, DeKalb will sell this land. They believe that the FAA regulation requires the property to be sold. It will be sold almost certainly for development if Brookhaven does not step in and preserve the forest. If anyone else gets this land, the forest will be gone forever. No part of the forest needs to be developed other than something that is needed to support green space, like restrooms, parking lots, and perhaps a nature center for educational purposes. I also want you to understand that this land, as it is green space. It's not open space, it's not a park. I get a little concerned as I go to public meetings about developments and stuff, that these terms are used interchangeably, and they're not the same thing. Within Brookhaven Zoning Code, Chapter 27-31, green space is defined as undeveloped land that has been designated, dedicated, reserved, or restricted in perpetuity from further development. There is no other public property in Brookhaven that meets this definition, none. What we do have are parks and open space, and it's time to change that. There are other more suitable properties available for any of the other uses that have been talked about, all of which would result in clearing the forest forever. I have a copy of the signatures on a petition to save the green space that has over 1,100 signees on it, if y'all would like to have a copy of that. In nearly every public meeting that I have been to, we have heard preservation of trees and tree canopy is among the top concerns for your citizens. This is an opportunity to answer that desire in a big way. Forests can be preserved permanently if Brookhaven uses a GFA loan, which is currently at between 1-2% rate, depending on which sort of loan you get. That equals less than $1 per month per resident, which are around $12 per year. Thank you.
Thank you.
Lori Geary and then Jennifer Langley.
Hi. My name is Lori Geary Talbert. I live in Brookhaven, lived there for almost 4 years. We're at 2207 Fairway Circle. And I just wanted to request to the board tonight, if you could just delay this vote and really think it through. One, on the financials, it's a lot of money for a city the size of Brookhaven to spend. And you're also talking about maintenance and police patrols and other things that go along with keeping up a massive green space of this caliber. And I think there is a win-win situation where you could have a huge chunk of green space, but you could also use the space for other, whether it's a swimming pool, whether it is a school. It would be an ideal location for a school, and I'm also the parent of two young kids at Brookhaven Innovation Academy. We came from a private school scenario. Never in a million years thought we would go public, and this came up and we were intrigued, and I can tell you, you have such a gem that is located in Norcross, and we desperately want to come here. We have incredible partnerships with Atlanta Tech Village, the first of its kind. Mayor Ernst, you told me that even your son's school at Montgomery Elementary benefits because class sizes are smaller. It's the same way at Ashford Park. Don't let the location of this school deter you from coming and taking a look at what you have, because I've heard a lot of people say that it benefits all other areas and not just Brookhaven students. Well, that's pretty powerful when you have parents wanting to send their kids miles and miles away to come to Brookhaven Innovation Academy that's located in Norcross, that says a lot. And it says a lot about the reputation of not just this school, but also Brookhaven as a city, that it supports its people, it supports education. And I think if you just slow down on this vote, it really could be a win-win situation for so many people involved and for the city of Brookhaven, for its residents, and for its taxpayers. Thank you so much.
Jennifer Langley.
Hi, everybody. I've been up here before you, and glad to be here again. Wanted to say that as a member of the board and the board chair, that we'd like for you to delay this vote for 90 days so that we have an opportunity to take a look at the feasibility of the land. We have an opportunity to meet with you again, met with you multiple times before. So that's all I'd like to say is just we'd like you to hold and continue to conversate with about this with us. Thank you.
Zinni Lynch and then Michael Lennon.
Good evening. Know many of you and look forward to getting to know others of you. And I'm Zinni Lynch. My residence is 2749 Ashburn Lane. I'm a resident of Ashford Park here in Brookhaven. I'm also the treasurer of the Brookhaven Innovation Academy board, as well as a parent of a five-year-old in kindergarten. And I'm not going to sit here and repeat everything that the parents have said, but what I would like for you all to consider is even if you make the decision to acquire the PDK green space, and I'm of the belief of like someone up here who has said before me that if you don't gain control of it, you will lose control of it in the long term. But I'd actually like for you to consider alternative uses for portions of that green space. And so that alternative use obviously is to house Brookhaven Innovation Academy. I would like for you to consider that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Michael Lennon.
Good evening. I'm Michael Lennon, 1802 Toby Road. My home is the first home on Toby towards Skyland that borders on the green space property. I've lived in this property for over 20 years. Before I even bought that home, I discussed with the airport, with my then county commissioner. From then on, it's always been slated to be green space. This board itself already voted yes to make it green space by putting the city manager into negotiations for this property. It's a vital, vital green space property, and if we don't get it tonight, it could slip away easily. The county is under no binding contract that they could not just sell it tomorrow. Thank you.
Lizzie Stallman.
Hi, you all know me. I was actually coming up here to speak about agenda item 7 on the consent agenda, but I want to make a couple of points first. I don't know how many of you got or were able to read my email, but there were a couple of points in there. But with all of the representation from BIA, it occurred to me, and I'm a former school teacher, what about safety concerns of having a school directly across from an airport? Has anyone thought of that? Has anyone thought of insurance issues? Has anyone thought of safety of children? So I'm going to throw that out at you, in addition to the fact that we are already losing green space in Skyland Park because of the much-needed DeKalb County School that will be going in there. It's something that has to happen. You know where my heart is. My heart is with tree preservation. It pains me to know how many trees are going to have to come down. However, it has to be. I don't think we need another school. On the other issue, and I see Christian's not in here, and I'm hoping that when this comes up on the arborist contract, that there can be some sort of explanation or detail on the cost of this contract. I know that the contractor, Charles Abbott, is going to be covering benefits, but this is quite a bit of an increase over our past arborist, and I certainly hope that the old adage, you get what you pay for, goes into play, because we really, really need a fine arborist that heads up a group of people that can really put the stop on deforestation. Thank you so much, and have a happy holiday.
The other people who submitted cards do not wish to speak. There was 8 that expressed support and another one that had opposed, but they did not want to speak.
Want to name them? Go ahead and name them. Go ahead and name them.
Oh. Lynn Brown with support. Deborah Kid with support. Thad Elliott, support. John Dean, support. Michelle Dean, support. P.D. Wagner, support. Ken Yates, support. Greg Cribb, support. And then Mr. Rob Turner was opposed.
Thank you very much. Any other public comment? Hearing none, closing public comment. See, we are at consent agenda. City manager, when you're out, item number 7 was questioned about the arborist and the expense and such by a member of the public. And before we go into that, if you could just kind of explain the contract.
My pleasure. With the resignation of the city arborist, Kay, we have need of of actual work and capacity to get these reviews done. I made the call to hire for the work through a contractor, our current contractor, CAA, until we could get a permanent public or community development director on board and let he or she be part of that hiring process and the decision whether we retain it as an in-house position or a contract position. So this is a full-year cost at $154, but I envision we would have this issue resolved well before, you know, a 12-month period.
Okay. So this is a stopgap. Okay, consent agenda.
I move that we approve the consent agenda.
Second.
Motion second. Approve the consent. Second. Any comment? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
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 It is consented to. Announcement, old business, new business. Consideration and approval of resolution for transmission of Brookhaven Petrie LCI 10-year update.
Patrice Reverend will address that issue.
As the council is aware, in 2005, the ARC granted DeKalb County a LCI grant to focus on the long-range planning for the Brookhaven-Peachtree LCI area. In 2006, that plan was adopted by DeKalb County, and the action plan was updated in 2011. The LCI program promotes greater livability in activity centers by identifying development opportunities and creating action plans to enhance mobility. The plan continues to serve as a guide to the development community for the city of Brookhaven. At this time, the department is proposing to submit the 2016 10-year update to the LCI, which is due to ARC on December 31st. Two tables in the document that's included in your package outline give an update on the progress of implementation of the projects identified in the 2011 action plan, including sidewalk and bike enhancements and traffic calming and other items. It also provides a new 5-year action plan, which is required by ARC for the city to continue to be eligible for additional grant funding through the program. The 5-year action plan was prepared by the Community Development Department with the support of the Department of Public Works, and staff is recommending approval of the transmittal of the update to ARC.
Any questions, or well, I'll first take a motion and then. Operate without
I
a motion.
Move to approve the resolution for transmittal of the Brookhaven P Street LCI tenure update.
A second.
Motion second. Comment? Is there any comment?
Good job.
Seeing none, all those in favor, say aye.
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 Unanimous. Next, resolution to amend budget fiscal year January 1, 2016, ending December 31st. Each fund the city services, city of Brookhaven pursuant to Article 5 of the city Brookhaven Charter, appropriating the amount shown in the budget as expenditures, adopting items for anticipated funding sources, and prohibiting expenditures from exceeding actual funding sources.
Good evening, Steve Chapman, Assistant City Manager. Before you this evening is our final 2016 budget amendment. This budget amendment does three different things. First, it funds, as we spoke about earlier, the vehicle maintenance fund for $1.1 million that is budgeted in the fiscal year 2017 budget. The second thing it does is it reallocates $320,000 of operating expenditures from Finance Department to Public Works and Parks based on some unanticipated overruns in those departments. Those costs were not budgeted sufficiently at the beginning of the year. We did anticipate some of these overruns, and for fiscal year 2017, we will not be having those overruns in those departments, so that's all been corrected. Once again, that section is just offsetting expenditures from one department to another, so there's no change in the general fund related to expenditures. The third and final piece of this is with the host fund that we spoke about earlier, and you'll be creating the capital projects fund. This is transferring $2,030,000 from the host fund to fund the projects in the capital projects fund in this fiscal year for those parks projects that we mentioned earlier in the workshop.
Okay, and do you want to do it all three at once, or?
Well, this is one amendment, so all of this is included as one action item.
Okay, so this is the number two action item. Okay. Let's first have a motion.
All right, I'll make the motion. Passage of a resolution to amend the budget for the fiscal year beginning January 1, 2016. And ending December 31, 2016, for each fund of the City of Brookhaven pursuant to Article 5 of the City of Brookhaven Charter, appropriating the amounts shown in each budget as expenditures, adopting the items of anticipated funding sources, and prohibiting expenditures from exceeding actual funding sources.
Okay.
Second.
Motion moved second. As people have missed the work session, can you talk about the capital project fund that we're...
Yes, I'd be happy to. The way in governmental accounting that is the best suited and best practice in doing capital projects is to create a capital projects fund that will consolidate various funding sources to complete projects. We are creating a capital projects fund this evening and funding it initially with these host revenues. The projects that we'll be funding are Parks and Recreation, Parks Department master plan projects, and a couple of public works projects. The reason that we use a capital projects fund is that it does not lapse at the end of each fiscal year. Projects are funded and then their budgets stay with them until completion of the project. Many times projects take more than a year to complete, i.e. if we were to build a city hall, that would be a project that would take more than 1 year to complete. So we would fund it and budget it in the capital projects fund, and then its project number and budget would carry through to it even over successful or successive fiscal years. That's the meanings for and the use for the capital projects fund.
Another huge added benefit is in the past, as a new city, we would describe and allocate funding to, let's say, the Parks Master Plan for $2.5 million. And there would be a list that would comprise the projects that got you to $2.5 million, but there were no controls of the sub-items below that. So if any one of the one items on that list went over, there was no mechanism, say, that what wouldn't get done. It just kind of ran out of money, for lack of a better term. With this, we are actually appropriating the dollars for each project. So, for example, the Blackburn Park Maintenance Building will have a set amount. It can't be rated for anything else without council approval. So we're going to start, and you'll start seeing this for sidewalk projects in the future, because my fear would be is you would appropriate $300,000 for sidewalks and not know what the subcosts were, use it all up on the first project and say, yeah, but we promised we'd get this project done, but there's no money to do it. So it's a way to actually designate the dollar amounts for everything you said you were going to do.
And what were the initial projects in that list?
The Brookhaven Dog Park is part of the Park Master Plan. Park Maintenance Building at Blackburn Park, again, it's part of the Park Master Plan. A playground at Murphy Candler Park, again, part of the Park Master Plan. A replacement bridge at Valvedere and Camille Drive. Peachtree Creek Greenway, some initial engineering and design for sections 3 and 5, and radar signage.
And on that replacement bridge, we were running late on a work session. Do we have any bids back on that?
Oh, we have cost estimates. The administration's recommendation is that we already have a approved bridge contractor. We're actually probably got more experience on bridges than most cities in this country at this point. We've done 2 bridges. Our recommendation will be going with the same design, use the same contractor, and we're working on bids now. I believe it's going to be under $100,000, but I would go with the amount that's in here just as a contingency, and you can reallocate it once the project is done. I think you'll see a recommendation from the administration by the end of the week on how to move forward on that. If we move forward by the end of the week, I think we'll have the bridge done before the bolt race.
Really?
This is very exciting. For those of you who may have driven down Donaldson Drive and seen all of our parks equipment behind some tall fencing there and wondered what in the world, this park maintenance building that has just been funded for Blackburn Park is going to house all of that, get it in an attractive location, not highly visible, and take care of that eyesore. And then, of course, the Murphy Candler Park Playground. And I want to thank everybody on council and staff for making these priorities, because that is a badly needed playground, and that Murphy Candler Conservancy and Murphy Candler residents have worked really, really hard over there and made everything so nice that it'll be great to be able to give them the playground they deserve. So thank you all for that.
Okay. There's a motion to approve. Is there any other comments? John?
No.
Okay. So we had the motion, yeah. But are we doing all at?
No.
Yeah, I thought we had to have an individual. So there was a motion. This was the motion on the first one.
Number two.
Number two. Item two. Is that good enough for you, Susan and Chris? Okay. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Okay.
Could you tell we were trying to make sure we knew what we were doing?
No, I'm just saying. Yeah. So the motion is to approve basically N2. I'm not going to read out the whole thing. All those in favor say aye.
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 I'll need a motion for N3, and someone can read it all out once.
I move that we consider and approve the resolution to adopt the budget for the fiscal year beginning January 1st, 2016 and ending December 31st, 2016 for 1, grants fund, 2, the vehicle replacement fund, and 3, capital projects fund of the City of Brookhaven pursuant to Article 5 of the City of Brookhaven Charter, appropriating the amounts shown in the budget as expenditures, adopting the item of anticipated funding sources, and prohibiting expenditures from exceeding actual funding sources.
I second.
Motion second. Any comment? All those in favor say aye.
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 Unanimous. Number four.
I'll move that we do a resolution to amend. Do I need to do the whole thing? You want it? Resolution item. This is item number four on the agenda. Would that do?
You can do. I would recommend that you use the letter number for new business and the item number. Just
new
to be clear.
Business number four. I move that we approve. I move that we approve new business item number four.
A motion. Is there a second?
Second.
Second by Joe. Any comment? All those in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
It's approved. And move consideration approval agreement on purchase PDK green space. Purchase Petrie DeKalb Airport PDK property. So there it is. There's a motion.
I move that we defer this agenda item for 30 days to the January, or about 30 days to the January 24th council meeting, to allow for all of the issues that were discussed before us tonight to be explored.
The motion? Is there a second? Fails for lack of second.
I move to approve the consideration and approval of agreement to purchase Petrie DeKalb Airport PDK property.
Second.
Motion seconded. John, you make the motion. You start the comments.
Well, this is just a continuation of the expression of our city policy, which is to acquire this property for green space. About 2 years ago, this council, of which three members were here, voted to change the comprehensive plan to have this property be green space as a priority. That matters in terms of our policy and also in terms of our zoning. The city council, before I was elected, passed a parks master plan. And in that parks master plan, it called for an increase from 5 acres per 1,000 residents to 8 acres per 1,000 residents. This is a long way to getting us there. Also, in that survey of that parks plan, the original one, 56% of the respondents said that trails and walkability was their biggest priority. Fast forward a year later, we had budgeted money last year for the acquisition of this green space. We voted about 4 months ago for the letter of intent to tell DeKalb County that we want to acquire the green space as a green space. So this is really just a continuation of our goals of the city of Brookhaven. There have been questions, and there continue to be questions. There will always be questions. The fact is, we've spent 2 years publicly debating this. We spent the last 4 months after the LOI looking for funding sources, vetting various opportunities. Staff is recommending approval because it is within our budget. It isn't within our ability as a city of Brookhaven to acquire. It fits with our policy, and that is why I made this motion to approve.
Lindley?
I'd like to begin by clearing up some misinformation. I am very hopeful that Brookhaven Innovation Academy will move back to Brookhaven. I think that is the hope and wish of most everyone I know. The school has been a surprising success in its very first year. And I know so many families who attend and are benefiting, and we would love to see it back here in the city of Brookhaven, just not on a green space that we very much want to preserve. And were it not for the desire of BIA to be on this green space, I suspect that many of these same people who are looking for a home for BIA would also be supportive of the concept of preservation of green space. And I simply cannot believe that we can't have the best of both, that we can't find a home. And I say we, and I really mean the BIA board, because of course BIA is a separate entity from the city now, entirely separate. It is a nonprofit entity, but I think we all wish them the best of luck in finding a home in Brookhaven. And we'll do anything that we as a city can do to support that effort. I want to clear up the misinformation. that there were meetings with me about BIA being on the green space. That never occurred. I've never met with the BIA board. I was never requested to meet with the BIA board. So information to the contrary that was circulated was not true. And had that meeting occurred, I would have said what I just said, which is express my deep appreciation for BIA and my sincere hope that BIA finds a home in Brookhaven. But let's talk about this green space, because this is a night that I think is one of the most important evenings of our council, that if we approve this evening, we will be following through on a promise, a commitment that we made for a very, very long time to the citizens of this city. And the national parks, when they were established, it was hard fought, and a lot of people had other proposed uses for the land that now constitutes our national parks. But today, our national parks are known as America's best idea. And I believe that this evening we could be establishing this PDK green space as Brookhaven's best idea. 33 acres in the heart of our city. How unique is that in an urban area? Tree canopy, an opportunity to be in nature right here, right in our community. So I'm very pleased about that. As we move forward on other green spaces, which I believe this council is prepared to do, I would like the people involved in those efforts, the neighbors of those communities, to take note that this is just an example of the city's intent to preserve green space as green space. Not to develop it as a baseball park and swimming pool. We have those and we love them. But to preserve green space as green space, not to provide parking, not to provide development or some grand master plan scheme to do something else with it. It is the true intent of this council, when we preserve green space, to preserve it as green space. And I hope that this very significant financial commitment is a signal to our citizens that we are sincere in our commitment to what has been asked of us when we were elected, which is preserve some of our green space before they pave over paradise. So thank you all for being here tonight, and I'm sorry for those of you who are disappointed from BIA. I'm confident that there will be a good home for BIA in Brookhaven to come, potentially a redevelopment, but I am very, very pleased that we are following through and preserving this 33 acres.
Yep. No, I'll yield debates.
So I'll try and be brief on this, but this is the largest decision that the city of Brookhaven has made on land acquisition. It bears significant time and focus from our council on what we're considering. One of the things that I would ask this council is, have you seen the appraisal? We talked about in the work session, the appraisal on this land that was given to us that I had tried to get for the last day that I just got during this meeting. Shows that the $5.7 million value that DeKalb County is saying that they need for this property is the highest and best use valuation. Not a fair market value. Not something that if the city of Brookhaven were to go in and say, look, we want to do a government-initiated rezoning on this property, we could actually get that as green space valuation at a much lower value, thereby giving the city an opportunity to transfer the property to the county at a much lower value. I'll start with this premise. We have unanimous support on this council to preserve this area as green space. There's no doubt about that. The only question that we talked about at the work session is, this is a question of funding. How are we going to pay for it? Because the $5.7 million is going to be at the expense of other things, whether that's paving, improving our existing parks, or additional police services. We have a fiduciary responsibility to try and spend the city taxpayers' dollars efficiently. I think we are leaving all kinds of opportunities off the table simply because we won't allow ourselves 30 days to take the look and explore these options. As we talked about in the work session, there are a number of those options, many of which preserve 100% of the green space. And the one thing that I cannot agree with is that this space is currently all green space. There's a huge asphalt public works depot on the frontage of Claremont Road seeping whatever chemicals from asphalt into the creek. Wouldn't you like to clean that up? The idea that is an efficient green space that we should continue is crazy. We have a brand new administration coming into the DeKalb County government who owns this property, who is friendly to the city of Brookhaven. And we hadn't even had a chance to talk to them about the purchase of this property. There are many other ways, which have been outlined in articles in the paper, about ways that we can monetize the purchase of this property. One of the things that came up tonight was that Brookhaven Innovation Academy would be a willing participant if the conversation could take place, that they could pay for the amortization of the $5.7 million, allowing us to use that money in other areas of the city of Brookhaven. But this contract we have before us, we're about to vote on, stops all of those options dead in the water because it gives restrictive covenants that do not allow anything in perpetuity of the property to ever be developed. Now, if you were spending money and buying a house, would you spend $6 million to buy a house to have the seller say, I'm sorry, you can't move into that house. You can't ever use that house. You can't do anything with it when there are other options. The restrictive covenants on this thing make me think that we have really dropped the ball on our responsibility for fiduciary duties. I think that there are plenty of options which should be explored. And I'm disappointed that the council is made the decision to steamroll past that, because as we discussed in the work session, there is no downside. Well, maybe there's some downside in that there are a few unknowns, but our contract with the LOI that we have with the county will allow us to continue to talk in an exclusive relationship so that nobody else can come in and steal this property while this discussion takes place, and that we can still, in 30 days, purchase it at the exact same price that we have here, and it's not messing up our chief of financing. So I don't know how we say no to exploring those options. That's it. Thanks. Joe?
Well, this certainly warrants comment on behalf of each of council members. So there are some issues going on here that haven't been raised yet that I'd like to make sure get put across. One is, this is a closed sale, which means it's between government entities and it's not out there for an open bid. That's number one. Number two, Christian, if I'm wrong on any of these points, please correct me. Secondly, as I just mentioned, there's no open bid on this. Secondly, we got clarification from the city manager this past weekend with a request to this chief operating officer of the DeKalb County, requesting whether or not we would have the ability to move forward and seek other uses for any portion of this land. And the response was that the sale was contingent upon it being maintained solely as green space. Correct? Okay. Third, and that was, I think, elicited in paragraph 4B4 of the proposed contract as referenced to us by our city attorney. What hasn't been mentioned and clearly stated is there is a time sensitivity to this in one respect, and that's the financing. We have the ability to source financing on this at less than 1% for 30 years, which will not be extended after this particular award session is over. The city, the state is abandoning. Is it the state that's abandoning that financing, or?
No, let me clarify that.
Please.
There are two aspects that are very advantageous to this financing that are time sensitive. One is just the access to the loan vehicle itself and the scheduling of that process, which they only meet quarterly or every 6 months. So there's that window. The bigger window is the $500,000 loan forgiveness aspect of the program. That goes away this year. That'll be only available to counties starting next year we're in, since we've made our request, we're part of that. So if we don't get it approved as part of this loan cycle, which will be decided at the end of January, yes, we could go back another low interest loan, but we would not be eligible for the $500,000 loan forgiveness.
And they're looking for a response. Patty, our grant writer, informed us today that the loan agency on this is looking for a response on how we act tonight, and they're going to be making their decision on January 24th.
True.
So a 30-day, even a 30-day hold on this potentially throws that into disarray. And from my perspective, given my previous statements, I just don't think that that's a risk worth taking. I think some of the options being put on the table are stretches at best. And to make comments, there were comments made that there are things that could be tried. There were a lot of options that were tried. They never really were voiced loudly. So you folks don't really understand a lot of the things that went on, because maybe you just don't have the time to participate on a daily basis when we're doing these kind of things. And I'm saddened to hear some of these comments. And I'm saddened that BIA didn't actually approach DeKalb County directly. They're the sellers of this. But if you would have gone to them, if they would have said, yes, you're not a government entity, you're a private entity, and it would have gone out for open bid. That's really the downside and the reality of that situation as I see it. As you folks from BIA know, it was the original council that initiated everything that made you who you are today. And the two of us are up here right now. We're the last two remnants of that. And I'm totally committed to the BIA. I served on your board in the beginning for a period of time. And Lindley, I'm going to have to correct you when you said you're surprised at the success of BIA. I always anticipated the success of BIA, just to get the record clear on that.
No, I said in the first year, it hit the ground running, and I was just surprised that its very first year is a success. I'm not surprised at all that it's a success.
I heard that loud and clear. Our objective was to have it become the state model for what a state charter school could and should be, and it's becoming that. That's exactly what we wanted, and it breaks my heart that we can't get you back into Brookhaven at this time. This is not the location to do it at. And when opportunities, you need to be making a more aggressive move on opportunities when they become available. You can't wait for the 11th hour to be doing this. We have pursued options to look for this venue, and it's just not there. And for us to take it out another 30, 90 days, it's too risky. The downsides outweigh the upsides from my perspective here on council. So, and I do agree with Lindley, and we've stated this on previous council meetings. I do think the decision we're making tonight, if this is approved, is really, the value of this is really going to be seen in the next generation. 30 years from now, it's kind of like, as you say, the national parks, or what Olmsted did in New York with Central Park. I mean, those are the kind of things generations down the road, people are going to say, boy, what a good decision they made, because it's a rare opportunity that we have. And that's my comment.
Okay. Thank you. Any other comment? But with that, all those in favor of approving the agreement for Petrie DeKalb Airport property, please say aye.
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 Against?
Nay.
3-1, it passes. There's no other business. Public comment number two.
Ronnie Mayer.
Still here?
He left.
Ronnie has left the building.
Okay.
That was for small miracles.
Okay, Mayor's comments. Thank everyone for coming out. Again, happy holidays. I think with this, the vote on PDK, I think that, you know, there, while we're going down these, not all avenues are completely closed off by this contract, that we may have chances to do something different in the meantime before the close of this property. There's been multiple opportunities are looked at throughout this process. If people had looked at our work session, looked at our paving schedule, when people talk about parks paving in place, our paving schedule with the investment we're making this year is going to fast forward us to have one of the premier streets in all of the entire region, raising our scores way high, cutting our backlog. As we just did today, we had approved monies to enhance our parks and on an ad hoc basis, and not to mention the money we dropped this year and continue to drop, and our police are again recognized as the best in DeKalb and around. So I don't think we are skirting our initial assignments. In fact, we are excelling at this. A good government is a government that can do multiple projects at the same time concurrently. It is not to focus on one thing and then another thing and another thing. It is to have multiple projects going forward. Again, you know, as I see Michael Diaz in the back, you know, and the other one big thing, you know, we do in this budget is approving $1 million for the design of the Peachtree Creek Greenway. That design thing is going to revolutionize our South. So as we move forward as a great city, we are going to move forward concurrently on multiple projects. And some of you guys will agree, some people will disagree, but we're going to move forward. So with that, I thank everyone for coming out today. Is there a motion?
Move to adjourn.
Second.
Motion to adjourn. Is there a second? Is there a second? All those in favor, say aye.
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 We're done.
All right, lawyering question.
Christian.
With...